coming to the stage, we have someone from, I don't know if you'll know him, Arrow, Woo! Doctor Who, Woo! John Barrowman.
And nephews out quad biking. You call it quad biking up here? Yeah? Four wheeling. Yeah, you have to be difficult to run with. Four wheeling. So I took them four wheeling, and my nieces and nephews and I are standing in this place I've gone to before in Palm Springs, and the guys, we're all in a semicircle, the guy's over there, and he's giving instructions, and I'm standing, he's kind of cute, and he says, well, don't put your feet down, because if you put your feet down, you're going all backwards, you're going to break your legs, and then we'll have to chop them off, we'll call you Peggy. Well, yeah, that's kind of funny. And he keeps looking over at me, and I'm going, inside going, he says, then don't put the throttle all the way back, because if you do throttle all the way back, you're going to tip forward, backwards, you'll fly off, you'll break your neck, then you'll take your head off, and then you'll be the headless wonder. Not a good joke. And he looks over at me, and I go, like, yeah, it's me. And he says, and when you go up the hill, don't pull away from everybody too fast, stay in a group, so you're being careful and nothing happens. So nothing happens. If it does happen, you're all together in a group, and you just keeps looking at me. He says, you know something? You look a lot like that guy from that TV show. Really? Yeah. Yeah. Except you look a lot older. All of a sudden, I didn't like him very much anymore. And when he said that, my nieces and nephews did this. They knew what was coming. He said, yeah. Not like he said enough already. He said, yeah. You look a lot like that guy who plays that Malcolm Merlin, but he doesn't have that old man hair. I'm going to drive one of those quad bikes up your ass. That's what I'm going to do. I walked over to my nephew Turner and I said, Turner, tonight at 1 o'clock, let's show him how old I am. We're gonna come back in the middle of the night, we're gonna slit all the tires to his quad bike. See how he likes them apples. It made headline news in Palm Springs. Quad bikes vandalized by unknown assailants. I'm just kidding, I didn't do that, I didn't do it. It didn't happen, no, I sent my nephew Turner instead, he did it all. Clean, just like Merlin. It was awesome. My 40th birthday, we went back, we had a big party, and I was told by Stephen Amell when I when I started on Arrow, I told him that I would be turning 50 soon. That was 5 years ago, right? Stephen said to me, because I've always spent my birthdays on a set, he said, well, John, if I'm there, I'll come out, either have a cake, or I'll deliver your cake in a Speedo. I never forgot it. Until my 50th birthday. All the lights go out. And Kelsey, where's Kelsey? Where are you, Kelsey? She's right there. Come here, Kelsey. You all know Kelsey, don't you? Kelsey's my Asian bitch. She's fine with it, don't worry. She's cool. What do you call me?
My big gay dad.
Her big gay dad, because when we're on airplanes, they think she's Mrs. Barrowman. They know they do, don't they? And then she says her, she's like, no, no, no. I'm like, ain't that that bad? And then they go, oh no, well, who are you? And she says,
his daughter.
You may as well be my wife. So yeah, she's my daughter when we travel. So I'm her big gay dad, Scott's the other gay dad, and we're a stereotype. We've adopted an Asian daughter. Going onto the plane, you turn to me, because I'm not allowed to lift my bags, right? And she's making it out online that I'm some kind of, like, bad person, making her carry all of my bags. All over Instagram, she's like, So I walk on the plane, and I turn around, and she's walking with my bags, and we get on the plane, I step on the plane, the flight attendant says, welcome aboard, Mr. Barrowman, and she goes, Ling Ling, bring your bag, Ling Ling, bring your bag. And then she sits down. she goes, that was the flight. She turned to the flight attendant and she said, $5, $5. We have fun on planes. So we're at the birthday party and Kelsey comes out. I'm sitting down and Kelsey comes out to me. She says, you're gonna love this. I'm like, what do you mean I'm gonna love this? The lights went out. And all of a sudden, the candles come from down the hallway. And here comes Stephen Amell and my friend Keith Jack in gold lame speedos, holding my cake. I about shit myself. And other things. I turned around and said, you know about this? She went, of course I knew about this, totally. I went, how did you know about this? She said, I arranged it. I said, what, you arranged it? She said, yeah, I was in the bedroom when they changed. I went, what? And then she says,
I got a video.
Got a rage, girl. Out of me. Video! Yes, she did. She said, I'll show it to you later. I'm like, deal. But it was awesome. They came out in the silk and the gold lame. I blew out the candles. I looked at both of them. And they had something written on their chest. Keith, unfortunately, is dyslexic. And he was meant to write JB on each of their chests, but he wrote BJ. I thought, yeah! Push-ups while they're prepping on top of each other, right? Totally on top. They wanted to get buffed and all ready for me, and they're doing push-ups on top of each other.
She filmed it all.
She filmed it all. You dirty bitch. Big round of applause for Kelsey, everybody! But the funny thing was, I go back to my room to watch the video, and I go in my room, and there's red all over my carpet. And all the lipstick they'd written BJ on their chest was all over my carpet. What's the one thing you don't ever do in a gay man's house? Leave a mess on his curtains or his carpet. It's terrible. I was scrubbing for days to get it all off of me. Fabulous birthday. Hey, how many of you saw the video of my husband? Have I told you this story before? I have, well, I'm fucking, I won't tell you again. Excuse my French. It's not Sunday, is it? Oh, in French it would be, what would it be in French? Quebecois. Qu'est-ce que c'est? Dimanche. All you un-Frenchies, shut up.
Dimanche.
Hey, you, get up here, come here. Yeah, you. Take your time, we've only got an hour. Oh, hello. Get up here. I just want...
Gosh, I'm trying to process, okay? This is, like, unreal.
It's about to get even more unreal. Tu parles français?
Je parle français, monsieur.
Et je parle un peu. Je parle français. Can I practice my French on you? It's BJ in a minute, I'll tell you. What's your name?
Tufik.
Tufik?
Yeah.
That's a great name. No, but it sounds like... Anyway. Close enough for me. Excuse me, I'm just getting a toothpick. Sorry, this is going someplace really wrong. So what did you say it was? How did you say in French? Do that again. Dimanche.
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 That's it.
Okay. Dimanche. Just do it again with the hands for me.
Dimanche.
I love Quebecois. Thank you. See you later, buddy. Do we have questions today? Do we have a mic for questions? No? Oh, we do. But I'm not going to tell you the story about my husband because I've already told you, haven't I? Wait! Don't get angry at me! Did I tell you about when I went back over to England? Okay, how many have heard it? Not enough. How many haven't heard it? You're gonna hear it! So, I'm in the jacuzzi at my house in Palm Springs. Scott, my husband's there. In our jacuzzi, we like to just go on the ground for a second and let everybody, so they can all see. I like to go, hello. How are you? I'm hung like a donkey. Of it there, girl. Like you've taken a blue pill. So I'm in the jacuzzi. When we go to the jacuzzi in our own home, we figure we're going nude, no big deal, right? It's our own house, we can do whatever we want, we're not afraid of nudity. So I'm in the jacuzzi, nude, FaceTime live. Right? Going, hey everybody, I just want to say what's coming up recently, and I'm going to be doing stuff, and it's going to be great, we're going to be out and about, and I hear splosh behind me. Turn around, my husband's in the jacuzzi. I said, you did not just walk behind me naked, did you? I said, yeah, no problem. I went, what do you mean no problem? I'm live on Facebook with 6 million people. And you've just shown them all your cock. Oh, yeah, well, I went to see Jungle Book. I don't care about Jungle Book. Because now everybody knows you're the king of the swingers. Off promptly, thank God for you people, because you made me go viral. So viral that I was in London a week later, and I'm sitting in the conservatory, or conservatoire, as my mother-in-law likes to call it, with my mother-in-law and father-in-law, because I go to see them every time I'm back in London if Scott's not there. So I'm sitting and I'm having tea and cakes and sandwiches, finger sandwiches, with my mother-in-law. Sterling, my father-in-law, is in the kitchen doing some cooking, and Sheila is sitting across from me, and she says, John, I spoke to Jackie this morning. I said, did you, Sheila? Yes, I spoke to Jackie. Jackie's such a wonderful lady. She says to say hello, Jackie does. But Jackie was telling me, you know, she said, Sheila, have you seen the papers today? And I said, no, Jackie, I haven't seen the papers. She might be reading the papers. She said, well, yes, Sheila, because Scotty's cock is all over there. She said, is it true, John? I went, yes, actually it is. And I told her this story. And she said, oh, dear. I do wish Scotty would keep his cocky in his pants. How do you continue a conversation like that, right? I said, well, I'll pass that message on.
Oh, would you, John? It would be so lovely if you did that.
Sterling walks in with more sandwiches and he says, I don't know why he just has it on. He shouldn't be ashamed, apparently he's well hung. First question. Yes. About that video now. It's still on there. Happy hunting. You disgusting pervs in the front row.
I'm thinking a little bit confused here. Dimanche is Sunday.
You're confused. What?
You were asking a question about French.
Yes.
I think the word you want is "va te faire foutre," which is "go fuck yourself," and not "dimanche," which is Sunday.
I come out of the doctor's mouth and go, suddenly I'm turned on. Did you sign that one, girl? Did you sign it for sure? I'm not going to say it, but how do you sign it? I don't want to say it. What she just said. Yeah, that too. Yes.
What was your favorite behind the scenes moment on Arrow?
My favorite behind the scenes moment. A lot of things have happened, and you know, part of what I like to do is just make people crack up sometimes, you know, by doing something really silly across from them when they're doing their close up. Steven's really easy to crack up. I mean, you know Katie Cassidy cannot say Nanda Parbat. You heard this? She calls it Amanda Poorbutt. We were doing a scene, and she's talking, she says, "Well, how do we get to Amanda Poorbutt?" Now you try to keep going, but Steven and I were like, and she just kept talking, like she knew what she was talking about. And then they went cut, and we all went, "Amanda Poorbutt?" I said, "Well, I don't know what it is, it's Nanda Parbat! It's only been on the series for 4 years!" No, there was another instance about laughing. Oh my gosh, it was, with Steven and I were, I've told you the one where we were doing a scene and I did the runaway and it did a kind of a dance. I told you that one? Yeah, do you want to see it?
Yeah.
We're doing Steven and I doing a scene and I'm doing all the evil Malcolm Merlin and he's doing all the kind of heroic Oliver. And I'm doing heroic Malcolm and we're doing it, we're acting our socks off and the camera finishes and I turn it around and I go, "Shoot that poison arrow." They love working with me when I do a really heavy scene. Yeah. Yes.
So do you think that there's any possibility that Jack can come back on Doctor Who?
I would love it, but unfortunately it's not up to me. It's up to the showrunner, the producers. I know the fans would love to see it. I would say yes, right? But it's all up to them, really. Would you like Jack to come back? Shut up, I'm asking the kid! What?
Kiss Peter!
Kiss Peter? I kiss Peter every Friday. Anyway, thank you for the four people who got that. Would you like to see him back?
Of course!
Well, then that's it. If there's any possibility, it would be with Chris Chibnall, because Chris Chibnall also showran for Torchwood. And so he knows Captain Jack, and it's a new lease on Doctor Who, and I think it'll be awesome. And let's just, fingers crossed, I'd love to, because Jack changed my life, and I will always be grateful to Doctor Who, and to the world, and to Whovians, because, like I've always said, you make my life awesome, and that's what Jack did. So I'd love to go back, yeah. Hi, Doctor.
I just want to say you are my first actual person in
that you've ever met
for celebrity, and this is my first question at a panel.
Is
so
it?
Bear with me.
Pee yourself.
I want to know what's your next character that you would like to be, if it's already somebody playing, or if, like, what show do you want to go on? And I know you're really good at dancing, so I know you're
We have rules at times!
I know you're good at singing as well, so would you go on a musical show, or would you go on a regular show like Arrow itself on a different universe? What show would you like to be on next? There we go.
I need a drink after that. Good lord.
What show would you like to be on next?
There's like eight questions in there. I've never thought about that. I mean, there's shows at the moment that I read for and I'm getting, you know, doing the auditions for, and we'll see what happens. I just did a big comedy show with a comedian over in the UK, a guy called Keith Lemon. I don't know if you know. Yeah, and we call it a piss take of Dirty Dancing a little while ago, and I was the director of Dirty Dancing. And it was kind of like a reality show making of Dirty Dancing, and they were the characters, and Keith is not the most gorgeous man in the world. And he put on the wig and the dress and everything, and it was hysterical. It got like the highest ratings for his show on ITV, and so they asked me to go back and do another one with him. And if you get a chance to see it, if you ever can watch it online, it's going to be hysterically funny, particularly what happens in the park. That's all I'll say.
I'm a big Hamilton fan, and I know you would be a really good part for King George.
Well, it's funny you say that, because I was asked to do it in London. It just wasn't going to work out. And also, there's a lot of other things that I want to do. It's a great part. I know you would love to see me do it, but it's only one song. And I'd sit in my dressing room becoming an alcoholic and drug addict like Liza Minnelli for the rest of the show. Apparently. But it's a great song, and who knows what the future may hold. Other shows, other characters I want to play, I'd like to do a comedy. I'd like to play like a good dad, really. Wouldn't that be nice? I'd like to play a gay dad. I'd like to kind of play a really great, outrageous gay character. I really would. I think it would be awesome.
Well, you already got practice with your agent, don't you?
With my age? With my agent?
Yeah. What? She's saying yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Great. Sit down. Look at you, Gorge. That was awesome. You did really well. Next time, one question. Just because you got a fez on. Yes!
So I was wondering what would happen if Captain Jack and Malcolm Irvin will meet in the same room.
That's an easy answer. Malcolm would beat the crap out of Captain Jack, and Jack would let him do it because he kind of liked it. And then Jack would start beating on Malcolm, flip him over, and make love to him. Totally easy. And you know what's really sad? Is some of you guys have written fan fiction about that shit. Got a little bit of glass there. I don't want you to cut yourself. Oh, great. Did you just hold like a sample? Oh! What? No, I'm fine. Plastic's fine. Don't worry about me. I'm just in the middle of a show. Don't worry. When I went in for my operation, y'all know I had my appendix out about 3 weeks ago. Yeah? It was horrible. Horrible pain. Everything was, you know, but the drugs were great. I was rushed in that night. They gave me drug medication and to go to the hospital in the ambulance. I said to my sister, because my sister took me to the hospital. We were writing at that time, working on some stuff. And she was in a panic. And we're in the car and I'm saying, God, can you drive faster? And she turned faster, faster! I'm already doing 80 miles an hour and I'm fainting! She was flying, but she was hitting every goddamn bump on the way. I get to the doctor's office, he says, there's no way you can make it to the hospital in the car because if it bursts, what's your sister gonna do? I went, inherit everything. That's why she wants to drive me. So they called the ambulance, they hooked me up to this machine, and I all of a sudden went, oh. Oh, this is awesome. And these two gorgeous men came, these paramedics, and put me on a stretcher. And they put me in the van, and they took me off to the hospital. And I get to the hospital, and they put me up in my room, and then they tell me I'm going to have surgery the next morning at 6 a.m. And I pressed this button, and this lady came in, and she put a syringe into that bag again. And I went, whoa, deeper. I said, what are you doing? She said, every time you touch that button, Mr. Barrowman, we give you drugs. Legally? She went, oh yes, you're paying for them. I went, well, give me more. Ding, 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 ding. She went, ah, and she gave me more. So the next morning, this guy walks in, and he walks in and he says, we have to take you to surgery, but I'm going to give you a little something to make you feel better. I'm like, okay. And he gave, I slipped out of the bed and I felt like this. And then I heard that I was really felt like this. And, oh, it was awesome. Colors were flying everywhere. The room was like going, whoa. It was like an episode of Doctor Who. And then this guy, I heard this voice say to me, I'm going to shave you. And I looked at him and I went, you don't have to, I'm gay, I'm already shaved. They wheeled me down through the hallway and I was out of it. The hallway's moving and it's going whoosh and all these nurses are walking past me going, great. Awesome. And then they're all gathering as they're pushing me in to the room where they're going to give me more drugs to get me prepped for surgery. And as I'm lying there, I mean, you're in a hospital robe, right? Unfortunately, I put mine on backwards. No one came to the hospital to give me clothes, so I don't have any underpants. Well, everybody's looking at everything. People are walking by and think it's because I'm famous. No, it's because it's all hanging out. And I'm sitting there, and the woman, the other nurse comes over. She says, oh, it's Barrowman, she's going to cover you up. I'm like, fine, thank you very much. And as she injects me again, and I go deeper into the state of drunkenness. And this guy comes over, and he says, Mr. Barrowman, I'm a huge fan of the show. Can I take a selfie with you? I went, no! Really? They put me in the operating room. They put me on the operating table. I'm lying there. Some man comes over, and he takes my thing, and he starts putting a catheter in it. I'm looking at it going, oh, can't feel a thing. And then he says, thanks for the selfie. That was the last thing I remembered. I think the guy behind me went, count to three, they went, one, two. Gone. Gone. If there's any selfies of me with my yin-yang hanging up with a catheter in it out of line, please let me know. Yes. Custom made. Yeah, they were my Zaza shoes when I was in the Kaja Fall. And you can't have them. They're too big for you. What size foot are you?
7.
Oh, you're a big girl. Yes.
What was your reaction when you found out that Captain Jack was the face of Bo? Because I fell off my chair.
You fell off your chair?
Well,
when I read it in the script, David and I were at lunch break, and the day before he got the script, and I don't like to read it well ahead of time, but David does, and he was reading it, and he came up to my trailer, and he said, don't tell me! I don't want to know anything! And he's knocking and knocking. I said, go away! Normally I'd have you in, but go away! Next day at lunch, comes back again, he knocks on my trailer door, and he goes, John, Sonny, get out. I'm like, no, I haven't ready yet, now piss off! Next day at lunch, I read it, I go to his trailer, David, can you believe it? I'm a loser. I can't believe it! So we go to my house. We all lived in the same apartment building, we called it Who Towers. Me, David, Russell, Billy, Elizabeth Sladen. We up and down the elevator, anybody who's guest starring, up and down the elevator, and we're in the Who Towers, and we're having a pizza night, and we're watching Doctor Who on Saturday, And David's there, and it's the episode where I turn around and I say, you know, the face of Bo, they called me, and Beauchamp Peninsula, blah, 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 all the lines. And as I was about to say it, I walked up to my window, and I opened the window, and I stood there like this. And David went, John, what are you doing? And I went, David, I'm just waiting to hear the nation's jaw drop. And boom. You're welcome. Yes. It's great to know that Jack becomes a big head in a jar. Oh, you've written this down.
I have.
Good for you. You might have found it before you got up to the mic.
Sorry.
That's okay. Oh, you're videoing yourself.
Yeah, yeah. Awesome. I need to prove that this actually happened.
Really?
All right, yes. Let's prove it.
No, girl, come around here, because the light's there. And I'll look like I'm 15. Yes, go ahead.
I have two questions.
Okay. You know what happened to that girl who asked like 85 questions? Fez girl. Yes.
Okay.
How old are you?
I'm 14.
Oh, okay. I'm gonna stick with you, pal. Alright? You look after me? Good.
Yes.
Go ahead.
My first question is, what's the coolest thing someone's ever asked you to sign?
The coolest thing or the... Okay.
And also the weirdest. Or
you're 14, I can't tell you. The coolest thing they've asked me to sign... Well, I get to sign a lot of things. I mean, but people, it's when, what I like the most is when people take the time, and you, I'm telling you the truth because Kelsey will back me up on this. Anything that I'm given, I take home with me. Scott thinks I'm crazy, okay? And anything that I, that, you know, like for instance, somebody made me a beautiful TARDIS, a wooden hand-carved TARDIS on a desk mount with my name, John Barrowman, on it, and that sits on my desk. So it's when people do that kind of thing, like they give me one and they have one for themselves and they ask me to sign it for them, or artwork that they've done, the fact that they've taken the time to do that and to really, really put their heart and soul into it, I think it's important, and I love signing that kind of stuff. So that's the coolest and the things I like to sign the most. I can sign a picture of myself anytime. I do it in the kitchen all the time. He's like, do you want coffee? And I'm like, yeah, here, it's my picture only. You don't care, do you?
I care so much.
Okay, the weirdest thing I've had to sign, the thing I can tell you, is when men and women come up to me and ask me to sign parts of their body.
That's gonna be,
the what?
That's what I figured it was.
That's not the weirdest. When you're, what's the age of consent here in Toronto?
16.
16. 16. When you're 16, I'll tell you.
Okay.
What's the other question?
Opinion on dabbing.
Who?
Dabbing.
What's your opinion on it? Don't judge. We don't like to be judged, so don't judge dabbers.
Okay. I do it all the time.
Do you really?
Yeah.
Ready? 1, 2, 3. It's dabbing or dapping?
Dabbing.
Dabbing.
Yeah.
Dapping.
Dabbing.
Dabbing. D. Dabbing. Got it. I won't get that wrong now. Are you done?
Yeah.
Sit down.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You enjoying yourself?
Yes, I did.
Good. Good. What's your name?
Rhea Gantra.
Lovely to see you here. You're all these people, look at them, they're all listening to you now. Who's this? You don't know, do you?
No.
You don't know each other? What are you taking pictures of the boy for? Yeah, he's handsome. Who are you with? Who's here with you?
Who's my sister?
Oh, you're right there. Your sister. Well, welcome.
Thank you.
Yeah,
Laura
good.
Johnson.
Say it again.
Laura Johnson.
Laura Johnson.
Laura Johnson. That's your sister's name.
Yes.
Well, thank you for introducing me. She's cute too. Just keep your hands off.
Next question.
That's so awesome.
Can you all still see me? All right. Yes! Shut up!
my dog is so fabulous, I actually named him after Captain Jack Harkness.
What language are you speaking?
English.
Okay, say it again.
I said you are so fabulous that I named my dog after Captain Jack Harkness because he is as fabulous as you.
Thank you. I have a dog named Captain Jack Harkness. Awesome.
And my question was, of all of the scenes on screen or on stage, who was your favorite kiss?
Who? Who? I can't see you.
Oh my God, he's coming up! I don't know. Oh my God!
The really funny part is I'm straight.
In a minute, you're not gonna be. He's fun, don't worry, he's cool. See? You've never shaved in your life? You don't know how to shave? Let me teach you. Just turn around and show them all your beautifulness. You were gonna kiss me? I'd say David Tennant is the best. Just see Kelsey, we'll do that backstage and we'll Instagram. Are you okay with that? So am I 100%. Don't be hanging. Is it as thick as your legs? He said, which one? Expect to see that later too. I'll post that on Instagram. It'll be me like this.
Oh my God, this is so bad.
Just see Kelsey over there, okay? Is this your, here, this is yours, isn't it? What was your name, by the way? Montana! Oh, Jesus. I never feel a wind rush in my hair. I suddenly feel like Marie Osmond on a good day. You have no idea what I'm talking about, do you? She sang a song called Take Me Back to Montana. Oh, Montana, you go over there and tell Kelsey to take care of me. Unless you want to watch the rest of the show. Yeah, what? You can say anything you like.
Okay, with that said,
No, don't say it.
Yeah, if anyone dropped that, like, I didn't get my camera, so...
Trust me, everybody got that. I mean, look, they've all got their hands up. In Montana, these bitches are crazy, so just be careful. He's mine, ladies. And he's mine, gentlemen. Are you here with somebody?
Yeah, I am.
Who?
My girlfriend. Oh, okay.
Sign it, you know. Where's your girlfriend? There she is there. What's your name?
Jessica.
We want you there. Jessica, I'm gonna borrow him for about 5 minutes afterwards. Is that okay? Are you cool with that? Do you wanna watch? I'm serious. I love you even more, Montana. How old are you?
22.
22. Oh, I remember 22. Rabbit City, right? Yeah. Why don't you guys go over there? You can watch the rest of the show from the corner, okay? All right, we'll see you in a minute, Montana. Jessica's walking slightly bow-legged. I love my job. Now you see why I love being me. That happens to me in the supermarket. People just walk up and take their clothes off and say, kiss me, and I'm like, okay, I'm a fish finger. Honest to God, I thought Christmas had come really early. Yes. Follow that, girl. No, go ahead.
I adore you. You look lovely tonight. I have a kind of a weird question. When you were younger,
what could be any weirder?
Well, I mean, I've noticed that you always rise to the occasion with your costumes. When you were younger, what were some of your favorite costumes for, like, Halloween and such?
Halloween? It was every day. Oh my God! It's like giving a little secret. Scott did the same. Scott, I used to put on the days when my mother had, she had a swing coat. You know what swing coats are? But it was like a 50s fur swing coat. Okay, it was the 50s. She kept it till like the 70s. When I was young, I used to like to put it on and do the vacuuming and put her heels on. Yeah.
Do you have any photos anywhere?
No. And do you think I would show you? Yes. I used to play dress up, not so much in the sense that to be outrageous. I just liked to dress up and pretend I was different people, you know. And when I used to play with my G.I. Joes, or what we call them action men in the UK, Montana. I would play with action men, and I would then bring in my sister's Barbies. They were called, you know, Cindy, the doll Cindy?
Yep. Yeah.
Yes. I used to play with them, but I used to switch their clothes. I was well ahead of my time.
Drag dolls.
Yeah, transitioning and everything, you know, it was all over. And I think that's why I like to dress up and do sorts of things. Halloween, it was an excuse for me to put on a dress and go out in high heel shoes, really, it was. And I even went to school dressed in as Halloween like that. And everyone was looking at me like, you're crazy. And I'm like, and? I just look better than all the cheerleaders. That's what your problem is. Funny that the footballers were very, very happy with me in those days. Yeah, so I don't really have a favorite, but that's what I used to do.
Well,
did you dress up?
I never stop.
Great. Don't ever stop. Always cosplay. It's great. Next.
Hello.
Oh. Hello.
Am I too loud?
What?
Am I too loud?
Yes.
Okay. I need to project.
You're asking me or telling me?
Okay. I'm telling you.
Hold it near your mouth, like,
yes.
Send it to me. There you go.
I need to project in more.
Say it again?
I need to project in more.
Awesome.
And in that regard, my background is mostly regular theater, and I like to do more musical theater. I'm really bad at choosing audition songs, and I have one coming up in a few weeks.
For what show?
I believe they're doing The Hunchback of Notre Dame. I'm an alto. Will you
out there, living
with
by
me?
The Seine, give me one day out there, like ordinary men, we're free to walk about. There, just one day, and then I swear I'll be content with my share. I'll have lived one day out there. What part are you auditioning for? don't know yet.
I don't know yet.
See, that's the problem. You don't know what you're auditioning for. Are you going to audition for ensemble? Are you going to audition for a singing part? Or are you going to audition for Esmeralda?
Singing part or Esmeralda.
Okay, go for the gusto, girl. So
I'm not allowed to do a song from the musical for my audition. What song should I do?
Right, so pick another Disney princess song.
Okay.
Yeah, and sing another song that shows off in the same style or the same and the same range and also the same emotional part as Esmeralda, because they're pretty much, I think Hunchback was Mankin, Alan Mankin, it was. I just did a big concert with him. Yeah, so look at some of the other Mankin songs and sing another one of those. That's what I would do. I was always told never to sing songs from the show. I always sang the song from the show. And I always got the part. Because when you're auditioning for something, the big secret is, what people don't know, sorry to get all technical with y'all here, they don't know what they're looking for. So you have to go in and show them. So I used to take the attitude, like Montana, I would go in, tight jeans, shirt, making myself look nice, right? Use what you got, girl. You got girls, right? Esmeralda, they're up and out. You know, don't get them out, but just put them up, right? And wear a dress that flows, that swings really nicely. So when you're singing and you're moving, it looks good, okay? And wear a little low heel. Don't wear flats. That's my big tip. Girls, when you're auditioning, don't wear flats. Wear a little heel. It gives you really good posture and lifts you up, and they'll take notice rather than walking in Uggs. Same with boys. I always say wear a little bit of a heel. Yeah. Okay?
Thank you.
You're welcome. I should do a musical theater seminar, shouldn't I? I see you, Ling Ling. Wait till we get on the plane tonight. We'll video it. Yes.
First of all, I just want to say I love the onesie, rocking the TARDIS.
Thank you.
I love Captain Jack and I love Torchwood.
Thank you.
What was one of your favorite moments in Torchwood filming with Yanko?
There were loads. And the one that come, I think I've told you the story before about the greenhouse and the kissing. That was one. Have you all heard it?
No.
Who's heard it? Three people. Who hasn't? Okay. So I'm in the greenhouse and I'll tell you this quickly. We're doing a kissing scene and I'm always worried about when I kiss another man that they're gonna feel comfortable. And so Gareth and I had a good relationship and I had to look like I was doing something. Right? How old are you?
22.
You're fine. So we're kissing and Gwen, Eve, has got to walk in and interrupt us. So we start kissing and we say, action! And she's got to come in and speak. And so we're going, oh, and I'm rubbing down there. And she walks in and she goes, what's wrong? She's like, it's just you two. You just warm me a little bit. I said, well, do it again. Here we go. Ready? And back to one. She goes back to one. So I start kissing. And she walks in and she goes, come on! The poor boy! And he's like, no, poor at all. So we go back to one, she does it again. About eight times she comes in and laughs. Finally I turn and say, Eve, we gotta get this. Gareth, I'm so sorry, your leg must be sore. I've been rubbing it so hard. He goes, that's not my leg.
You're making my convention, just so you know.
Am I? Awesome. Listen, I got about 8 minutes to go. Would you like me to sing a song for you?
Yeah!
Okay, I need your help on this one because I need to look at the lyrics. But in the chorus, every place I've done this, nobody sings along. Come on, Toronto. I'm not going to sing along. All right. Ooh, Adelaide Kane just texted me. You know Adelaide? Yeah, from Rain? Yeah. Oh, there, Matt Smith just texted me. See you on the plane. Looking forward to a ride. Oh. Kelsey, I can't get my phone to work. Something's happened. Oh, there we go. All right. So, Kelsey, anytime you're ready. Before we start, I just want to say to you guys, seriously, you make my life awesome. I love you for it, and I love the fact that we can come, we can talk, just be like friends. I love doing these things, and you're great to me, and that's why I like to do these things for you. So thank you very, very much. Good luck on this one, girl.